be with me. Everyone sitting in here, dog, you're here to make progress, to improve yourself, to learn, to develop yourself. That's why we've all joined Toastmasters. Mr. President, Toastmaster of the evening, outgoing President, my fellow Toast members, and most welcome guests. It was 2014, September, on a fateful autumn evening. Autumn is the season after summer and before winter. I drove to Berry Park in Luton, wanting to find out what Toastmaster is all about. I got there. There were about 12 people in the room, just like we're all sitting here. And I sat in the middle. I was watching what everybody was doing, and I'm thinking, what's going on here? Much people. When it was table topic, I was picked on. My legs were shaking. And I thought, what am I going to say? And I was like, if you win the lottery, what are you going to do with it? And I thought, oh, that's easy. If I win the lottery, just came up, I gave my speech, and I went back to sit down. I didn't attach any meaning to it. What pushed me further was the feedback I got. And I will never forget one of the comments I got. It was like, you're going to be a promising Toastmaster. And I held on to it. And I thought, you know what? That is a positive feedback for me. At the end of the meeting, I was picked on again. I was like, why did you come to Toastmaster? And these were my exact words that day. I said, I'm tired of people asking me to repeat myself again. More so, I cannot say any word that has H in it or TH. So I've come to improve myself. I still struggle a bit if I get carried away, but I'm getting there. Now, these certificates, they're not my making. If you guys were not here, there's no way I could give a speech and achieve the certificates. So I really, really thank everyone. Thank you very much, fellow Toastmasters. Is it Jill that sits there and is like, put Wenda, stop moving about? Is it Dennis that comes and gives you that warm hug when you come in? Is it Angela, when she gives you feedback, is like, anyone that has H in it, she will write it out for me and that. So I'll go back and go, home, house. Anyone that has H in it, I'm still learning, I'm not perfect. Is it Peter? Is it David that drives me to other Toastmasters? Is it Tony? Adi, thank you for the rides occasionally. Mr. President, thank you everyone. I can't but mention a lot of names here tonight. I really appreciate you guys. Is it Elsa that will call me on a Saturday morning? Like, we need to enter your speeches. Thank you guys. Thank you, thank you. Let me give you a story. I've got my friend here tonight. I've been meaning to bring her to Toastmasters. Today I think she got bored and she just pressed on the bell, came to my house. As soon as she came, I said, yeah, we're going to Toastmasters. And she goes, oh, I'm not prepared. I didn't tell my husband. So we sat down, we had dinner. When we started to go, my granddaughter ran to the door. Grandma, Grandma, what happens in Toastmaster? And I was getting ready. I didn't answer. Do you toast bread? And Mimi said, no, 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 no. Do public speaking. What's public speaking? Do you put bread inside the toaster and it pops up? That's how she speaks. She's very dramatic. Then Bumi was trying to explain to her, no, it's where you give speeches, public speaking. And as we were driving down, thinking, Toastmasters, Everything about me is Toastmasters. I eat Toastmaster, I drink Toastmaster, I sleep Toastmaster. To the extent that if I'm walking along the street, something pops up, I'm like, oh, you can make a speech out of that. Somebody says something, I can make a speech out of that. Fellow Toastmasters, what have I learned since 2014? I've been a president. I'm presently the VPE of another Toastmasters. I've visited loads of Toastmasters. I've met lovely people like you guys. What else can I ask for? My friend will call me and is like, if I pick the phone, oh, not Toastmaster today. My second name is Toastmaster. I love you guys. Thank you guys. What I'm expecting is my badge with all the alphabets in it. I'm going to end my speech with a quote from Jess Owen that says, I once becomes colloid, friends get no dust. I once become colloid, friends get no dust. That's you guys. If I meet you on the street, I have to stop and say, oh, where are your fellow Toastmaster? If I meet you in the shopping mall, I'm back to stop. Dennis, if I meet you on the road, I'll get that hug. Mm-hmm.